Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Solace. It seems to be a little cool right now, so I'm guessing it's nighttime. We took a little nap last time, right at the end of the last episode. It is indeed very cold out here. Let's pop on our torch, see what that does. Not a great deal, but enough. Whoops. Put that down. It won't let me. That's fine. Let's teleport way over here to this area where it wants us to go down in here and figure out where that flying orb went. Find out where it's going. So, I might have missed something by teleporting down, but it's obviously got to come down here at some point. So, temperature's much warmer down here also. So it went that way. How we know it went that way is unknown to me. So no tower parts, but a bunch of secrets. Fine. You can keep your secrets, game. Don't freeze up on me. Don't do it. Alright. Me and my milkshake don't want none of that. You ain't allowed to freeze up on us. But we're back in the dark caves. And, well, not even caves. We're back into the freaking underground tunnel system that this civilization is built, following a strange glowing green orb that we're just like, that's odd. A spaceship came by, like a flying saucer type ship came by, dropped that thing off, and flew away. Let's go find out what it does. That seems like such a good idea, doesn't it? If it were me, I'd be like, nah, man. No. I'd rather die here. Come on, game. Load up. This is about the only thing in this game that I can make an honest complaint about. This game is very, very well made. I'm enjoying the crap out of it. But these loading times, it's kind of like when I first played Bloodborne. The game is excellent, but then you got these loading times that just break your immersion and take your time. It's not good. Everything else in the game is pretty good, but not the load times. Load times are not good. Now, it's my suspicion that we're getting rather close to the end of the game, though. The reason I say that is because the whole point of this game is to build that tower. And we've only got a handful of debris, like 4 or 5 pieces left, and a power source. I suspect that either that orb is the power source, or it's taking us where we need to go to get it. Come on, game. Please. You guys don't reckon it's frozen, do you? Because that's a possibility. Could be stuck on an infinite load. Which would be annoying. Wait. It fixed itself. We good to go. I'm sorry about the wait on that, but not really much I could do. But oh, I should have been charging my flashlight. I'm an idiot. Were those here before? Those stalactite things here before? Moisture tabulates. Passage of the Drowned. I don't remember that area. Not to say I haven't been here before, but I don't remember that area. Passage of the Drowned. Does not sound familiar. And this hallway does not look familiar. But since it's here, I was going to say I was going to eat something, but I don't need it. I'm full up. This is a library. This is library straight up. Okay, there's the orb, obviously. Can I throw one of those in there? No. There's four things I need to activate somewhere. Get it to open. Something. It's very possible that something is up on top of these shelves. What is this? Aha! There are books that need to be adjusted. By adjusted, I mean they're like secret shelf books. Pull them and the door opens somewhere. Makes like a hidden passage or something. I'm missing one. Ah, well. How about I'll take some of that water? Ah, there it is. Alright. Achievement: Bookworm. Follow the path and look for the strange orb. Passageway of the Drowned. So the orb went that way. I'm going this way. Not very far, it looks like. What did that do? What did that do? Anything? I'm gonna check up here on these shelves. Oh, come on. There we go. Really? I would have bet money. There was something on one of these. Looks like I would have lost that bet. Although, there are some strange things going on here. Like that door being open, for one. Secret caves are meant for experienced explorers. Well, at this point, I think I'm fairly experienced. I was experienced enough to avoid that, wasn't I? The maze. The poisonous maze of Dea, where we have lost two sacred artifacts. 10 of us have tried to retrieve them and have not returned. A small one was given along, but it did not bring luck. Poison? Need to watch a little bit more carefully for those. I will find out where that orb went later. I found me a secret. Always be going left. That's the trick when you're in a maze, is pick a wall and stick to it. Is that a cold one? It is. Well, like I said, always be going left, so hug this wall. You may have to go through the whole maze, but you'll eventually find your way out. Well, I don't like this. Alright, I made it. Except I made it back to where I started. At least that's what it feels like I've done. Get up there. No, this is different. Give me them buffs. I'm running out of flashlight, so I'm going to use torch for a while. I seem to have abandoned my strategy. Of course, I didn't really have a lot of choice whenever I came across the drop-off. Alright, we do have a teleport somewhere that we can go to if we need it. Close to the beginning of this place. Not what I was hoping to find. It was a dead end. Alright. Well, time to go back. All right, enough is enough. I thought we could find some. Thought we could find a secret quickly, but I guess not. What does this say? The orb. Ooh, they know about the orb. 21st year after Exodus, we will help our Sky One create a second tool, a new orb of great power. It will harness the shadows beneath the waking world and bend them to our whim. That does not sound like a good thing, if I'm being completely honest here. I've got an achievement called Tomb Raider. I guess for opening so many of those boxes. Sent chills down my spine. You, us, they say. Oh man. I wish I had like some sort of binocular so I could zoom in on whatever that is over there. I'm gonna do this. Mostly just because I just now saved. I gotta know what this stuff is. Oh, it's bad. Oh, it's bad. Get out of the water.
Warning. Operator, cold and wet. Temperature dropping.
Yeah, that's acid. Mm-hmm. And I got an achievement that says this swimming pool is awful.
Biohazard detected.
What? Uh-huh. Well. Maybe don't bring a torch in there. So, I don't know what that says, but that's acid and no good. No bueno. And the direction I'm obviously supposed to go over here. Is more or less telling me. Need a med pack. Get that. Are those like poisonous spores or something?
Biohazard detected.
Get through here.
Warning. Toxicity levels critical.
Yeah, but they're going down.
Biohazard detected.
All right. So I don't know if what's going on there with that. If it's touching the droopy down things, or if just that area in general is bad. But when I brought a torch in there, it exploded, so I'm guessing it's just the air that is bad. What's this? The Conspiracy, 1 of 11, okay. Adar Sum's brother, Kagoni, showed us the ball once we finished work. It is the power source of the Sky Ones, like their son. He left for the Hollow Land, where the Red Water lives. Their arrogance is tiresome. This is 1 of 11. The Sky People always return to the Red Water. It is a dangerous place, a place of pain. They say the Sky One's purity lets them withstand the heat without malice. They say all their secrets are kept here, all of their power in one place. I see you up there. What the crap? No. I saw that man up there. It's going through the tunnels. Okay. The Conspiracy, number 3. Waika found a piece of the ball. Must have fallen from the great mill during construction. She was holding it when Kagoni found her. His face twisted, and the wind whipped around and threw her. He took her and the part away. We haven't seen her since. That's not a good sign. Passage of the Drowned, 4. Part of the ball? It looks like it. Maybe part of the original orb or something. But it's got skulls on it. If I take that and use it, I'll get some health back.
Health improved.
Conspiracy number 4. We can no longer trust the Sky Ones. We must save ourselves. We must strike first. Dakato and I met to create a plan. If we take the ball suspended by the Great Mill's sight, we may be able to turn it against them in time. I will tell Varsa. The plan is in motion. The prodigal sibling only appears an hour after daybreak and leaves at supper time. We will try to take the ball and roll it into the caves. It will be hard for them to track us there. Quit shaking. Once we have the ball, we will force them to reveal the secrets within the great volcano of the Hollow Land. Any power, any tools, any resources a person could need will be there. We will balance the scales with the Sky People, with the Sky Ones. Tonight is the night. We have it. Immediately after sunfall, we used power blades to sever the ball suspension coils and rolled it carefully down from the mill. Its blue eye slowly pulsed. It won't be long before we unlock its secrets and turn them against the Sky Ones. Dakato says that the ball has a different mark on it from the last one he saw, which was carried into the Hollow Land. There must be another there. The land of the Red Water, the volcano, is where their power sources reside. The ball can help us. It opened. Dakato opened it. Something is coming. I can hear it when it becomes angry. It was Dakato's fault. The moving darkness. The moving smoke is here now. So somebody opened it and a thing came out. This is the guy that I saw. These people are different than those people. Is there a way up top? No? Alright. Oh, come on. Well, that's unfortunate. I'll get up there. There's definitely something going on with this. There has to be, yeah? Fine. Shush. Alright, I'm gonna put a teleporter over here because this is where I need to end up going. But I want to see what's over here. I see light over here, and I want to know what it is. It looks like a camp of some sort. I'm not going in that water. I don't trust it. It is a camp. Nice! Some food. Some water. And refill this. And that, carry this with me. Actually, go ahead and use it.
Operator health improved.
Okay. All right, I guess I have to go in the water. No, I don't. Where am I supposed to be going? That way? Okay. Fine by me. I'm fairly certain this was not the way I was meant to come here, but I'll take it. Hey, you. Don't hover over me. No. Shortage of sleep. I don't care about that right now. Explore this area because of reasons. Where are you going? Oh, that's not good. Alright, so it went through there. Yeah, where does this start? Over here? Okay, well that's a bunch of people who got smooshed and dragged. A heavy cutting rock. Water. And some more inscriptions. Alright, let's read these. It came for us, and it almost got me. The Spectre, dark blades and gusting smoke. I hid in my door as it passed by. Everyone else was running in a huge group away from it. There were bodies. I saw the bodies. The thing came from inside it. Within the ball, we all gathered and watched Ikado and his followers roll it past, and a while later, the screaming began. Someone shouted that it came from inside. They opened the ball. All right, let's go find the other portions of this script. So I'm guessing that's what caused this mess. Babies on the shelf. There was really nothing in here, though. It's quite unfortunate, actually. I'm not happy about that. I was wanting there to be something in there because it was like blocked off and you had to teleport your way in and stuff. I was hoping there would be something, but that's fine. More candles. More food, which I'm actually alright on. The only thing I'm really short on is sleep. And we're gonna take care of that in just a moment. Alright. It's only me now. I think I'm the only one who hid here. Everyone else ran up to the shrine room. I haven't heard anything for a few hours. It's a dead end. There's nothing but a brick wall there. I think it followed them. The thing. It has been 3 days since everyone fled. There isn't much food left here. I should move on and scavenge, but I'm too afraid to leave. I could look at the shrine, but the Dark Spectre never came back this way. Is it there? Well, we are going to find out. I assume that was the shrine room and everybody blocked themselves up in there. It tells me to go this way, but I saw the ball go in there. So up there is where we're going to go next time. And we are going to lay down and go to sleep back here. Why? Because reasons. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, as always, please hit that like button. Comment, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. And I will see you next time.